Hello and welcome to part 10 of the Pokemon Shield journey. A Pokemon I caught was this Pokemon because it's a grass type and I think it's gonna help out in this water type gym. We're gonna see how much potions we have so we can get ready for our gym battle, and we have 6 potions. We're gonna buy some more potions. We go to the shop over here, and we're gonna buy a potion, and we're gonna buy 5. And we're gonna buy 5 super potions. And now we're gonna head on to the water type gym. Okay, we're gonna start our gym mission. Okay, you can't leave your Pokemon box, Link. And we're gonna walk in to the gym mission. I see a lot of pipes with water. And there's our exit. It's a maze. You have to press the buttons to get rid of the pipes, or the water that's in the pipes. And we have to battle this gym challenger, or gym trainer. And I brought out this Mincino first because I used a TM that made it learn Seed Bomb. And here comes Mudshot. Our speed fell. We're gonna use Seed Bomb one more time. Here comes Echo's voice. That was a critical hit. And this Pokemon is down. And we defeated the gym trainer. And we're gonna press this button. And then we're gonna press this button. Okay. And now let's try pressing this button again. And now we can make our way across. Let's see what this red button does. Okay, we can't have that there right now since we need to hit that yellow button. And we're facing another gym trainer. It's gym trainer Heather, and she sent out a Krabby. We're gonna keep on using Seed Bomb since it's super effective on water types. And here comes Arden. Here comes another Seed Bomb. And Krabby's down. A critical hit for us too. Corpfish. I'm going to switch my Pokemon because I don't want Nincino's Seed Bomb to run out. Here comes Corp. And we're going to use Mega Drain. And that was super effective. Here comes Bubble Beam. That wasn't that effective on Lombre. We're using another Mega Drain. And he's down. And we got back to full heart or HP. And he leveled up. We're gonna switch. Whoops. We're gonna switch this Pokemon with Mincino because his Razor Leaf you can use 25 times, and that's a lot. And now I think we go here and press this button. And then now we can make our way across. And now there's water over here. And we're gonna try pressing that red button over here. I feel like we're gonna need to battle this person, so I'm just gonna battle her. And the Remoraid. We're gonna see how good this Pokemon can battle. We're gonna use Razor Leaf. Here comes Psybeam. Not very effective? Or it's not very effective. I mean, it didn't say anything, so I'm guessing it's just effective. And that's not very effective. And Remoraid's down. And I think this Razor Leaf does a lot of damage. We got another level up. And Choodle. I'm gonna keep this Pokemon out since the Razor Leaf does a lot of damage. He avoided the attack and hit him to Water Gun. That wasn't that effective either. We're gonna try again. And Choodle's down. With a critical hit. We defeated the gym trainer. And we're gonna go past here and see what this button does. Actually, I think we're supposed to press that blue button. Or actually, I think we're supposed to press that red button if we can get past that. So we're gonna keep that clicked and try pressing this button. And then we're gonna try going this way. I think I have an idea. I think that stops. I'm gonna click that red button again. I'm gonna click this button. And go this way. Over here. It stops those. It can stop that one. I think I get it now. I think we have to press that button. And then go over here. Press the red button. And then press the light blue button. And then I think we can just make our way over this way. But before we go through that door, we're gonna heal our Pokemon. So we're gonna use our potions on that. Okay, now we're gonna use it on Mincinaw. We're gonna use one more. Then we're gonna sort out our Pokemon. We're gonna let this Pokemon go first so I can save our good Pokemon for later. And we cleared the gym mission. Actually, I think I'm gonna let Mincinaw go first. And we're gonna do a dance before we go. And now we're gonna head into the gym. Well, we were in the gym the whole time. We're gonna head into the gym stadium. And there's the water type gym leader. I'm pretty sure her name was Nessa. Yep, it's Nessa. Okay, we're gonna defeat Nessa. She has different type of balls, and she takes out Goldeen. Our Dynamax band is ready, but we're not gonna use it. We're just gonna use Seed Bomb. Which is super effective. Here comes Agility. She has three Pokemon, and I'm gonna use Seed Bomb again. She uses Water Pulse first. That makes me confused. I still use Seed Bomb though. And I don't accidentally hit myself. And Goldeen has a little bit of HP remaining, so we're gonna use Swift. Become Water Pulse. Let's see if we don't accidentally hit ourselves. Okay, yup. Goldeen is down. I'm gonna switch my Pokemon and let Lombre have a chance in this battle. And we're gonna use Mega Drain. Here comes Bite. Here comes Mega Drain. And that took half of his HP, or a little more than half. And we're gonna use Mega Drain again to finish him off. I'm pretty sure it should finish him off. And he's down. She has one more Pokemon left. And we're going to use our new Pokemon because he has our highest level as a grass type. We're going to switch our Pokemon into our new Pokemon we just caught. I'm switching because this is our highest level grass type Pokemon and it has the strongest grass type move because it did the most damage. It looks like she was saving the best for the last. And this is the time we Dynamax and use Max Overgrowth. Here comes their Dynamax. Most gym leaders throw it with one hand, but we throw it with two hands. And here comes our Dynamax. Here comes our humongous Pokemon. And here comes Max Strike. We're still hanging in there. We're using our Max Overgrowth. Okay. Grass covered the battlefield. And now everyone's HP is getting healed, even the opponent. Which is one bad thing about Max Overgrowth. Okay. He's still hanging in there. And Dreadnought's down. And we defeated our second gym, the water type gym, with the gym leader Nessa. Leaf Tornado. Let's forget an old move. Let's see what it does. We're gonna trade this with Cotton Spore. Okay. We got Leaf Tornado. A lot of level ups. Agility. I'm not gonna learn agility right now, so we did it with no Pokemon down. Her face looks surprised. And we're gonna get our second gym badge. It's right. No, it's not next to our grass type gym badge. And we can catch Pokemon up to 30. And we're gonna go to the fire type gym. Okay. What TM? TM Whirlpool. I think that's a great TM. And we got the water uniform. And now we're heading out of the gym. People are saying what a fierce battle, and we need to head over to the food place. seafood place. I don't really know where that is, but I'm gonna try finding it. I think this is the seafood place since there's a bunch of people just waving over there. And it is. Okay, we're gonna celebrate our victory. It's a seafood town. I can see why it's a seafood town. I like the power of wishing stars, since it can make Pokemon Dynamax. He hasn't had a chance to speak with us. See you later, Chairman Rose. Okay. We got another TM. This TM is the user gets revenge for a fainted ally. If an ally fainted in the previous turn, this move's power is increased. See you later. Or whenever we meet again. And here's Hawk. Okay. He's gone there. He's heading towards the mines. And I think I'm gonna heal my Pokemon and save the mines for the next journey, number 11. These Pokemon fought very well today. Switch our Pokemon up a little. We're gonna put Raboot back here. And we're also gonna bring back Corvisquire. We're gonna check our boxes. We're gonna bring him back. Change him with Mintino. I'm gonna check one more thing by going over here. Okay, now we're gonna ride our bike this way. And we're gonna come back over here. I'm gonna take my Pokemon back. I'm gonna take him. I'm gonna send him to the box. Yes. Wrong button. I'm gonna send him to the box. Okay, press the wrong button again. Now we're gonna press the right button. Okay. Let's check if there's any mints in over here. I want to catch this mint now. And I'm just gonna use a quick attack. Used helping hand, but it failed. We're gonna use quick attack again. Didn't go sing, but he avoided the attack. We're gonna use quick attack one last time. Here comes Echo Voice. I'm gonna catch this Mincinnow so I can put it in the Pokemon daycare thingy next to us, so maybe I can get an A. But one has to be female and one has to be male, so I'm gonna check. We're not gonna give him a nickname. I'm gonna send him to the box for now. And I accidentally bumped into Stuffer. Before this video ends, I'm gonna see if they're both male or both female, or one female and the other male. Because I want to try getting a Pokemon egg. But we have to look at our box. Check boxes. Get this Mincinnow. Check summary. Okay. Okay, I have too many Mincinnows. Check summary. Oh, I got one that's different. So I'm gonna move him into any of them. And then I'm gonna give them to the Pokemon daycare dudes. And we're gonna head on over. To the daycare place. And keep some Pokemon here. I'm gonna leave some Pokemon. Oh, we could have just done it from the box. Select. And this one too. Okay. And that'll be it for today's episode. I hope you enjoyed seeing me defeat the second gym battle.